Hey guys, Sean Nalawani here, seannal.com, bodytransformationtruth.com, and the question being answered today, is creatine safe for teens? So I get this question a lot from teenagers who are getting into bodybuilding or who play sports competitively, and also from the parents of those teenagers who are wondering about this topic. Creatine can be useful for producing a small increase in training performance either in the weight room or during explosive stop-start sports. And it also has effects on increasing intramuscular water weight, which can give you a slightly fuller appearance if you are someone who responds well to it. So is creatine safe for teenagers? The simple and short answer from a pure physical perspective is that there is no specific difference from a physiological standpoint between someone supplementing with creatine at the age of 16 or at the age of 60. It doesn't affect hormone levels, so there's no particular reason why creatine supplementation would be any less safe for a teenager versus someone who was older. We obviously can't say anything with 100% certainty when it comes to nutrition or supplementation, but creatine is the most researched sports supplement available, and the data basically shows that when used properly, creatine monohydrate is safe for use in otherwise healthy people. So safety really isn't the problem. The only problem comes in when you have a teenager who hasn't educated themselves when it comes to proper training or nutrition, isn't following a consistent, properly structured program, and is looking at supplements for some kind of quick fix to put on muscle. I get these messages all the time where a teenager will say something like, you know, I want to put on a quick 5 or 10 pounds, which protein powder and which creatine supplement should I use? In those cases, I most definitely don't recommend using creatine, because supplements are nowhere near being a quick fix. The results are only going to be modest, even if you are training and eating properly. And just using them on their own without a proper program in place, that's literally going to do nothing at all for you. So if you're a teenager who wants to get in shape and you're just starting out, supplements really should be the last thing on your mind. You're not going to get something for nothing, and building muscle really is a lengthy process that requires a lot of time and effort and patience. And your focus needs to be on doing the proper research first, mapping out a plan for yourself, and then developing the discipline and the work ethic to stick to that plan long term. And if you're not willing to do that, then you can forget about building an impressive body altogether, because it's really just not going to happen. Now, if you are a teenager who is serious about this, and you're putting in the time in the gym, you're tracking your workouts, you're tracking your progress, you have solid nutrition habits in place, and you understand that supplements are only gonna give you a small extra boost at best, then in that case, I really don't see any problem with giving creatine a try, as long as you have a few extra bucks to spend on it. There are a lot of teens out there who train hard, who are patient, who are disciplined. I know plenty of younger guys out there who are more motivated and harder working than guys twice their age. And so if this describes you, then I don't see any issue with it. I personally trained very hard in my teens. I was actually more serious about it back then than I am now. And I used a few basic supplements at that time, and creatine was one of them. So yeah, in that case, it's fine. And I'd highly recommend checking out my creatine supplementation guide, which you can find over on my website. I'll link it here and also in the description box as well. Make sure to read through that, because it will show you how to use creatine properly step by step and in the most cost-effective way. Also keep in mind that anywhere between 10 to 30% of the population are known as creatine non-responders. So if you do use it and you don't notice any benefits at all after about 2 to 3 weeks, no increase in body weight and no increase in strength, then you're probably a non-responder and you can stop using it and save your money. So that's really all there is to it. Is creatine safe for teens? From a physical standpoint, yes, but I would only recommend it if you're serious about your fitness plan, you're implementing it with consistency, and you understand the role that supplements play in your program, which is only a very small one overall. So I hope this was helpful. The official website is seannal.com. You can follow me on social media here. The links are in the description. If you want to grab a fully structured step-by-step muscle building and fat loss system that covers everything you need to know in terms of training, nutrition, and supplementation, then you can grab my body transformation blueprint by clicking here or by heading over to bodytransformationtruth.com using the link in the description box. And if you enjoyed the video, as always, make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. Talk to you guys again soon.